Hi everybody, welcome back to the beauty portion of my channel. I'm back today with a review of two palettes that I have from E.L.F. This is going to be my E.L.F. week, I guess, because I completely forgot that I even had a lot of things that I had gotten from E.L.F., which is really sad. Like I said yesterday in my other video, I normally am really good at knowing what I have and using it, so I don't waste my money, my time, and the product, but for whatever reason, this week has just been my, you know, enlightenment video. What? It's pretty much been my enlightenment week where I just remember everything that I have and I kick myself in the ass to use it. So I used one of the two palettes you're about to see for the look I have in my eyes today, and I'm very happy that I actually did it and it looked good. If you're wondering what's on my lips, I actually used my NYC Twistable, City Proof Twistable Lip Color on my eyes. What the hell is wrong with me? On my lips earlier today, and it's around 220 right now, and it's worn down to this, you know, look that it's at now. It's like a pink look. And then I layered on some of NYX's Butter Glass in Creme Brulee. And I like the way it looks, so I kept it. So if it looks awkward to you, I'm still learning how to do makeup, so don't judge me. Thanks. But anyways, we're not here for a look. We're here because we need to look at two palettes. So these are the 32 color eyeshadow palettes. I forgot the name. One is an everyday, is this one with the colors, and then this one is in neutral or a natural shade. The one I use today for the look on my eyes, which I'm very proud of, is the everyday shade or everyday palette. And this one has a lot more color to it. It's, as you can see, here, let's just zoom in. Alright, so we zoomed in, and this is the palette that I use on my eyes today. I used these two purples here. This one was for the outside corner of my crease, and then this one was for the smoked out area in my crease. This was the base shade right here, this gold, and then just went over it all with this nice subtle purple or lavender color there. But as you can see, this palette comes with an array of different colors, and I'm in love with all of them. I still have yet to use these blues, but the blues look phenomenal. Let me just give you a little swatcheroo of what it looks like. Look how pigmented that is. It's so pretty. I love that color blue. Excuse the other two swatches on my hand, but you can't really tell. No, you can. Right there. Can't reach it. Anyways, but this is the palette that I used on my eyes today, and I honestly am in love with it. I don't normally go to this palette for a lot. I actually like to use the other palette that I have, the natural color palette, because that's the one I use mostly when I want to get transition shades for smoky eyes, but I didn't use it today. This one, I don't know why I turned all the way back to focusing on me. But this is the natural one. This, as you can see, has more earthy tones to it. It has a lot of, like, deep forest greens in it. There's one right here that looks almost green. There's golds, there's blacks, deep, deep metal shades, neutral shades. This is the area that I usually use right here for my transition shades, and that's the area that gets used the absolute most. I haven't really ventured off into these yet, but I'm fairly certain I can get a really good look out of that area in particular. But I honestly prefer these palettes to any of these NYX palettes, because these NYX palettes honestly have no color pigmentation at all. I don't know if it's just me, if I got a bad batch or whatever, but I regret even thinking about buying these in the first place, because it was such a waste of money to me. This is the Smoky Fume or Smoky Shadow palette. I'm fairly certain it was either $6 or $10. If it was $10, just save your money and go get an e.l.f. palette, because you're going to get much better color pigmentation, color stay. They're not as flaky as these are. These are awful. I hate these palettes. So don't always assume that because NYX is a little bit more considered of like a higher end drugstore product, that it's going to be necessarily better than the other cheaper versions of them, because honestly, I still have yet to see a better eyeshadow from NYX than there is for e.l.f. So, just thought you should know that. But that's my review for today. I know it really wasn't a good review, but it was a review nonetheless, and you get to see the palettes and see the colors that come with it. So if you're interested in those palettes, either of those palettes, I will put the link down in the description for you so you can go right to the site and order them, because I'm sure they are always sold out. I went to go look the other day if they had any more, and they do. They're in stock now. They're usually always sold out, so if you really want them, you need to go and get them now because they're going to be sold out pretty soon. If you want a tutorial on this eye look, I am finally comfortable enough to do tutorials. I'm comfortable enough to do tutorials now because I feel like I've finally accomplished what a smoky eye should look like. So if you want to see the look that how I got this look on my eyes, let me know and I will be happy to do that for you. But for now, I'm going to go and get ready for a baseball game because I'm going to a baseball game. So I will see you guys later in a new video. Keep watching for my influencer Voxbox, my spring fling Voxbox opening, unboxing, what do you call it? So I will see you guys there, and hope you guys have a good day, hope you guys have a good weekend, see you, peace.